be alive from the greatest country in the world. It is Fox Across America with Jimmy Failla, a man who is not a nunchuck expert nor enthusiast. This next guest is, and he could have used them this weekend because he was almost in New York City, where you need at least nunchucks to get down the street these days. The Attorney General of Arizona returns to the program, Mark Brnovich. Hey, man.
Hey, Jimmy, and don't forget, it's not only the nunchucks, but it's also the shurikens and the Okinawan size I'm an expert at as well. So a whole plethora of martial arts weapons at my disposal.
Well, listen, Bruce Lee, you're going to need that as a minimum if you want to hang out here. When you told me you weren't coming to New York this week, I just assumed you couldn't get your nunchucks on the plane.
Well, you know, as a result of New York's anti-chucks laws, that case went up in the Supreme Court. That helped open the door for all these states now to allow people to practice their martial arts as they see fit. And I will tell you, you mentioned Bruce Lee. I'm a huge Bruce Lee fan. And never forget, be like water. Be like water.
Nobody tags a reference on the radio like you. Like, if I make a song pun, you come back with five. Like, you deserve more credit than I think you get out there. You know that?
I know. I just feel like, yes, you're right. You're right. But, and, you know, and remember, for all you that are recovering from your weekend New York City hangovers, be like water can also be a reference to drink a lot of water.
Dude, you want to talk about New York City hangovers? I woke up this morning and my Face ID on my phone didn't recognize me. Like, I couldn't unlock my phone. I'm like, all right, I think it's time to get help.
You got to take the pantyhose off your head. You know, you got to get the mask off. So.
Hey, girl.
No. You know, Jimmy.
I know what you meant. I'm just laughing.
No, you know, like, good. Look, I don't want to give criminal tips here today, but you know that if, and I'm not encouraging anyone to engage in crime, but if you, like, wear, like, the stocking mask with the eyes cut out or the lips cut out, like, people can still kind of identify you, they'll lock it on your eyes. But the pantyhose not only distort your face, but you can see out of them. That's why, like, in the 70s, those guys were robbing all the banks. I mean, Attica. What was the Al Pacino movie with
Dog Day Afternoon?
Dog Day Afternoon. They should have gone. Yeah, remember they had to take the pantyhose off the beginning and they blew their covers. So, Attica.
Mark Brnovich is on the line. He's the only attorney general that gives out crime tips. We love him for it. No, you're the best. That is a great movie, by the way. I wanted to talk to you about crime for a minute because it is spiking everywhere. There's a lot of elected officials telling us that it has nothing to do with bail reform. Speaking in your capacity as an attorney general, do you think these bail reforms have contributed to the spike in crime?
Absolutely. And if I can give you a true story that breaks my heart, when I was a gang prosecutor years ago, I had a case where someone robbed a 7-Eleven and he shoved a shotgun in a clerk's mouth, this 15-year-old gangbanger, and there was a bail hearing. And I adamantly opposed him getting bail. And the judge said, oh, he's a young guy, you know, I don't think he's going to hurt anybody. Released him. And a week later, that guy killed an 8-year-old girl because she threw a water balloon at him. And so I think about that case every time someone talks about, like, oh, we need to let these folks out. And the reality is there are people that are very dangerous, that mean us harm, that quite frankly need to be in jail or need to be in prison. And we cannot trust them to be out while they're waiting, you know, to go back to prison, so to speak. And we saw that in Wisconsin. We've seen it in other places. And between the bogus bail reform efforts, and then you throw on top of that, you get these clown prosecutors that won't prosecute cases, you know, property crimes. And, you know, what happens? You're going to end up with more people doing smash and grabs and these organized retail theft cases where people are, you know, in Chicago and San Francisco, all these liberal cities now, you know, the inmates have taken over the asylum.
It's crazy. And, you know, I was looking in L.A., okay? You know, like, first of all, our mayor is a buffoon, Bill de Blasio. He tells us New York is safer now than it was 8 years ago, despite the fact that the murder rate is up 40%. George Gascon said that in L.A. too. He said, but for the homicides, everything else is doing well. But in where I come from, the homicides really are like the headline, are they not?
Yeah, it's the old, what is that old sick joke? Lincoln, how'd you like the play? You know, it's like, it's absolutely asinine. And this is the thing, as you know, Jimmy, about the far left, is that I don't think they care. I think the systematic attempt to undermine institutions, to undermine law enforcement, it's all designed to bring about their Marxist revolution. And part of that is that, you know, they don't believe in property rights. I mean, go open the Communist Manifesto. It's all about eliminating private property. And so this notion that, you know, well, that doesn't belong to, you know, CVS or, you know, Sears, or I guess there is no more Sears, but, you know, whatever. Pick one of those cake eater department stores in New York City go to. Like, what is that? Neiman Marcus or whatever?
A Macy's. Yeah. I get it. Bloomingdale's. I'm with you.
I worked at Macy's at one time. I don't consider that too elitist. I'm thinking like Neiman Markup, like those kind of stores, right?
Yeah.
And so they feel like, well, that's not really their property. And what they don't understand is there are people that worked hard to produce those goods. There are people that invested their time and money to open those stores, to open those businesses. And there are people that their livelihood and their insurance relies upon being able to, you know, a consistency and certainty in the application of the law and being able to sell their goods and services without having a mob come in and basically take it. And this is the stuff that should really, really worry people. It's not only this. I mean, obviously, there's the catastrophe at the border and the cartel seizing control. But this notion that fundamentally we are not going to respect the rule of law and respect other people's property, this is dangerous. This is what happens in third world countries, places like Venezuela or, you know, Cuba, before they have their revolutions. And I think the far left, the AOCs of the world, they know it and they don't care. They want this chaos. They want this disrespect for property. They want people to feel so aggrieved that they can go out and destroy other people's property and steal their stuff. And it's just wrong. It's fundamentally un-American.
It's so true. It's bizarre to watch it play out in real time. But like the far left wing of the Democratic Party would defund the cop from the village people if they could do it. And that's not good. I mean, no one wants to listen to YCA. You know, you need the M in there. You know what I'm saying? Just, it doesn't have the same ring. I mean, you're a music guy. You know, sometimes these syllables really do matter.
Especially when you're in the Navy, so to speak.
He's always good. Mark Brnovich is on the line, folks. He is the Attorney General of Arizona, as well as a macho man, if you're just joining us. So there you go. We're out of Village People songs, by the way. So let's nip this in the bud.
The three I know. So I'm out of ammo on that one.
Let's have this talk, though, because in Yuma, Arizona last week, we got some crazy goings on at the border. How did that become a hotbed? I didn't understand it, but one day we got out of bed and we were just looking at these images. Have the cartel shifted their focus? Is there something going on we don't know?
Good luck. I mean, Jimmy, the border has been broken for the entire time the Biden administration's been around. As you know, we sued him and we still have lawsuits against the Biden administration trying to force them to build the wall, trying to force them to implement the policies that say that if people have deportation orders, they got to be deported. And so, you know, what the cartels have done is they've seized this opportunity with the Biden administration decriminalizing and incentivizing illegal immigration, and they're using it to their advantage. And so, you know, we're going to see these blips and these spikes in certain areas, but make no mistake about it, we are in a record pace as far as more than 2 million people will legally cross the border this year. We're seeing a record amount of fentanyl cross our southern border, and I keep telling folks that the looming man-made disaster facing this country is not climate change. It is the man-made disaster that Joe Biden and his enablers like Cartel Kelly have created along our southern border, because this is having a toll in human lives. It's going to have a toll in cost of social services, and it's a problem now that's not only going to be around for next week or next year, but it's going to be a generational problem, Jimmy. And that's why I have been trying to sound the alarm. We've talked about it before, and you run out of words, you run out of adjectives, and sometimes people get numb the statistics. But I mean, like I said, a record amount of people, a record amount of fentanyl is coming across our southern border, and now they are strategically taking advantages of gaps in the border in their overwhelming communities along our southern border. And if you talk to, I was just down in Yuma County, you know, I go to the border frequently to talk to law enforcement, and they will tell you that they've never seen it this bad. And we know that it is really, quite frankly, a problem that the Biden administration created. And, you know, we were just talking about, you know, what's going on with stores and everything else in this country. And I would just say, from the drug cartels to the smash and grab squads, the Biden administration are now organized crime's undisputed champion, because they have enabled organized crime not only in our inner cities, but they are enabling organized crime, the cartels at our southern border, and every American is going to pay a cost for this.
Yeah, I don't. It's wild, but I don't think anyone could argue the point you just made. You know, could argue against it, because they really have emboldened criminals and on every front. They've undermined the cops on every front. The only way we're going to get these cartels under control is if we get video footage of them not wearing masks. Then they're going to have a big problem.
And you know, look, I mean, no meaningful conversation we can't as a country have any meaningful conversation about COVID that should not begin at the border. Because really, I mean, you know, the Biden administration has like allowed, it's crazy for me to think that you have hardworking, you know, DEA agents and marshals and FBI agents that are being forced to get the vaccine. And yet if you cross the border illegally, you don't have to get the vaccine. We know that there are people that are risking losing their jobs. And yet the people coming across the border, the toughest question they get asked is whether they want the single room or the double room. I mean, right? I mean, it's just, it's crazy. And like I said, there's a cost, a human cost, but there's also a fiscal cost associated with this. And as you know, Jimmy, we have multiple lawsuits against the Biden administration over the unconstitutional vaccine mandates. And we know that even from data, according to ICE, that more than 80% of the migrants are unvaccinated. And yet Border Patrol isn't routinely testing them, and instead they're just being released into our communities. And so, you know, a chain is only as good as its weakest link. So I just say shame on the Biden administration. I just think they're basically full of crap, quite frankly, because they say one thing and then their actions are completely contrary to what they're actually saying. And I guess what's the cliche? Who are you going to believe? Your lying eyes or, you know, yeah. Joe Biden?
It's funny. I will have you know, we actually have a phenomenal cover song on this show. We play of Lion Eyes by the Eagles called Biden Lies. And it's actually really well executed. I have to send you a copy, you know, since you're not in New York to live it up this week. Go ahead.
Well, we'll be in New York shortly, hopefully, God willing. But I'll tell you what did Bobby Dylan used to sing? And I guess I'm not making a joke about this, but, you know, blowing in the wind. How many deaths will it take till Biden realizes too many people have died? And we're not talking about COVID. I am talking about the overdose deaths. I'm talking about the cartels and the inner city violence. And, you know, we unfortunately seem to be becoming numb to it. And it's wrong, and we need to do something about it. And, you know, President Biden, you know, I almost long for the days when he was back in the basement, because he wouldn't actually be proactively hurting this country.
Yeah, I agree with you there. I mean, I Kamala, who's supposed to be the border czar, I'm reading reports today about how she redecorated her vice presidential office, which is just bananas, because I keep, you know, there's no time to go to the border. But if somebody wants to go to Crate and Barrel, move a few picture frames around, she's game. Have you just ever seen like public officials more indifferent to the plight of the people they represent in this administration? Like, it's kind of sociopathic, is it not?
Yeah, the only thing I guess I would say is that, you know, if it wasn't for Jimmy Carter, we wouldn't have had the Reagan Revolution. And in England, was it not Macmillan? Who was the prime minister before Maggie Thatcher?
Yeah.
But without him, you know, we don't end up with, you know, Margaret Thatcher and, you know, helping tear down the Berlin Wall and everything else going on. I mean, you know, frankly, I think that, as one of my buddies told me recently, that we've gone from the Pineapple Express to the Cartel Express with the Biden administration. And, you know, it's just, we got to be doing everything we can to push back.
Yeah, defense wins championships, and we ain't playing any defense, and we ain't winning any championships. But you're right in saying necessity is the mother of invention, and Biden presidency might usher in, you know, 12 to 16 years of conservative dominance. With any luck for this country, really quick before I let you go, it is the holiday season. Are you forcing people to wear 31 masks to the Christmas party at the AG's office like they're doing here in New York?
The short answer is no, but I will tell you that I look forward to us getting together for Festivus, a holiday for the rest of us. And I look forward to our feats of strength, and I want to know, can I bring any martial arts weapons to the feats of strength?
Yo, you're going to need to bring them just to keep our Christmas tree from getting burnt down out front. Okay. So, yes.
You guys can hire me as security. Maybe I can get on Greg Gutfeld's show finally by being out there taking on the tree destroyers.
Yeah, you know? They need a bouncer. If Tyrus is on our show today, but on the days he's out of town, they do need a bouncer. So I'll put it a good word for sure.
And I'll tell you, this is the big thing. This is the pro tip I'm going to give everyone listening today. Mm-hmm. Is A, do not get your wife or girlfriend or significant other bath bombs. Not a good Christmas present. That's one. Just so you guys know. And two, if your significant other says they don't want anything for Christmas or the holidays, do not believe them. Go out and buy something. So I'm just, 'cause those are two pro tips from someone.
He's saying this with a black eye over his face. I can see him on FaceTime. I'm kidding. But no, I know. It's the old, I'm not hungry, I'll just have a bite of yours. And then they eat the whole thing.
Oh,
I get it.
Oh, my. Yeah, so someone who's been married for almost 25 years. Let me just tell you what. My wife and I know this now. If you want something to eat, order your own thing, because I'm ordering this because I want to eat it all.
Nobody who just wants a bite of yours. They do just want a bite of yours, but it's a bite a crocodile would take. That's what they don't tell you. It's a bite, don't get me wrong. Oh, too funny, man. Listen, I love talking to you. Happy holidays. I'm sure we'll talk again before Santa comes, assuming he's allowed to come. But a great hang as always, my man.
Yes, exactly. And I really do appreciate it, Jimmy. Be safe.
You too. Be well. There he goes. Thanks, the great. Brother.